So here we go. Oh, here we go, guys. Here she comes. Ooh. What do we got? Oh my god, it's twins! I was kidding! Oh my god, I can't freaking believe we got twins! Oh my god! What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Ark Survival Evolved. That's right, you guys, we are back, and oh snap, is it gonna be an awesome freaking day? But first, if you guys enjoy what you're about to see, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter at CouchPotato1898. Link is down there in the description. So, last episode, guys, was amazing. We got a brand new 145 female T-Rex, and that thing is absolutely incredible, guys. That freaking monster of a T-Rex is all ours, and I'm so freaking excited about that. But last episode, we also received a gift from one of my friends on the server, Casual. Oh, hello. Mastercraft Raptor Saddle? Are you freaking serious? That's in a green drop. Hang on. I gotta check that again. I just got a Mastercraft Raptor Saddle blueprint with 72 armor and 160 freaking durability from a green drop. How the hell does that happen? I'm gonna start checking these damn things. Holy crap. That's amazing. Okay, well, we're starting the day off well. But anyways, guys, we got that gift from Casual, and that Rex, apparently it hatches at 10k health and 435 melee damage. It hatches at that, guys. It hatches at that. And my freaking T-Rex that we tamed yesterday had almost 8k health, and it had, 409 melee damage? That's insane amounts of differences between our stats. Now, granted, he bred to get those stats, but still, I mean, that is ridiculous amounts of freaking numbers with that. But anyways, what I'm trying to get at today, guys, is I want to incubate that egg, and I want to get that T-Rex out, and I want to get that T-Rex claimed for us. Now, how are we going to do that? Well, I've had kind of an idea about an incubation room, an incubation chamber, kind of an area where I can do that, and it's right over here. Oh my good god. Look at all the Rexes. So, it certainly looks like they've been leaving their T-Rexes over here to go into the boss fights and stuff like that. So, this is kind of my idea altogether. I'm going to have an incubation chamber right up on top of this, right here. So, I'm going to build a separate incubation chamber away from the house. I'll probably have one at the house as well eventually, but I'm going to have a bigger dinosaur incubation chamber over here where I can incubate my Rexes. And I can have kind of a nice pen for them. I'm going to pen it off and kind of make it a second base. That way, I can keep my T-Rexes here. I can have maybe a breeding pair here of the perfect Rexes. And then I can keep pushing out eggs and I can keep breeding battle Rexes. And then instead of having to walk all the way from the cliff to Blue Ob, we just have to walk about 35 feet down to Blue Obelisk and then put in all of the artifacts and all of the stuff, all the drops from the dinos around the island. So I think that's going to be a very, very good idea. And it's going to be a time saver whenever we start going into the boss arena, because truthfully, once we go into the boss arena once, then I'm just going to keep going in, you know, I'm just going to keep going in and keep going in and keep grabbing the element, keep grabbing the engrams, because unfortunately, as of right now, the only engrams that are available on the center is the tech replicator and the gauntlets. So once I go in once, after each time I go in, I'm just going to have to unlock it with admin commands, unless the mod author slash wildcard decides to come out with more of the tech engrams on the center. So that's a little bit unfortunate. But anyways, we'll cross that bridge when we get there. We're still quite a ways away from getting tech tier anyways. So inside of my Fabby, check this out, you guys. I have enough stuff inside of here to make 12 air conditioners. So we'll go ahead and get those guys crafting. We'll get all those guys crafted up and stuff like that. But inside of my industrial forge, which I still need to make the fourth one. I could probably crap one out in about 30 minutes, but I don't need to right now. It's not necessary. But inside of this one, I've still got 5,900 more metal, and this one I've got almost full of charcoal. This one almost full of freaking charcoal. So, needless to say, we're pretty good on that front. But I wanted to show you guys something. Yesterday, I was out leveling up Sunset, our Mosasaur, and why did I walk outside? And I found an Alpha Mosasaur. Now, I could not kill it. I got it close to death. Like, not even kidding. The thing was bloody, but so was I. So it took me down from about 21,000 health to about 6,500 health. So I pulled out. I was like, I'm not risking losing Sunset. So I pulled out of that. But guess what I found and killed? I found a Tussotuthis. Look at that. I didn't know they gave you a Tussotuthis tentacle. I think that's super cool. Now, I don't exactly know if you can mount one of those, because it says this trophy proves your worth as a deep sea hunter. But then again, you can pretty much classify these as trophies as well, because see, this trophy proves your worth as a hunter. So I don't exactly know if they're crafting ingredients or if they're just kind of there. But I also have 36 black pearls, guys. So we might be able to go down and tame us a Tussotuthis eventually once Sunset gets her health back, because I'm sure she doesn't have it back yet. So let's see. Are they done? Oh my god, they don't stack anymore? Okay, I guess I gotta carry 12 singular frickin' AC units. Okay, well that's okay. I guess I can work with that. Alright, but anyways, guys. So, what I want to do is I want to get the structure up over at Blue Obelisk. And it's going to be kind of... it's going to be a bigger structure. So, it's going to have... I'm probably going to have some behemoth gate. I'm probably going to have at least one behemoth gate there. But I want it to have a similar wall design to this, except instead of having fences, I'm going to have walls, and then I'm going to have fences on top of the walls so that I can have kind of like a catwalk system made out of foundations and walls and stuff like that, and it'll look pretty cool. But we have a decent amount of work of ahead of us today, guys, especially because that whole structure has to be made out of stone, because Rexes spawn over there on Blue Obelisk, as well as Therizinosauruses, so we're definitely going to have to make it out of stone. But it's going to be a ton of fun, guys, and we're going to be able to incubate that Rex egg today. Let's go ahead and make sure that it's still in there and it's still got enough health. Let's go ahead and double check. I think I put it in here. Yes, it's still in there and its egg health is still at a quarter. So we're going to have to make sure that the incubation temperature is perfect before we place it down. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and get some stuff made up. Oh god, there's the hair glitch again. I'm going to go ahead and get some stuff made up either over here or over on Blue Obelisk Island, and then I'm going to break ground on the structure. And then when I've got an update, I'll bring you guys right back in. Alright, you guys, so I wanted to bring you guys back in and show you a little bit of an update as to how the incubation chamber is going, how it's coming along, the construction and all that stuff. So I had to switch spots because of the amount of freaking dinosaurs that were over there. There was no way I was going to be able to clear them with just Barry B. Benson the Baryonyx. So let's go ahead and show you what's going on with this thing. So this is the main incubation structure, and if you'll notice, right there, I put sloped roofs right there. And it almost looks like a garage door to a warehouse. And I didn't intend for that, but it kind of looks very cool, and I'm going to keep it like that. So it's got an amazing view. Just look at that view. So the reason why this back wall is blown out is because I'm going to put glass in right there, because I want it to have a nice view from the back of it and everything like that. And I want to be, I'm actually thinking about putting a door frame right here with like a ramp down, and then having like a nice little deck and like having a nice little lookout and stuff like that. Because, I mean, this is just a beautiful area. So while your babies are incubating and stuff like that, you can come back here and pop a cold one and sit down and look at the view. So I just think it's kind of a nice little area. This area is super pretty. I'm surprised I've never built in this area before, but anyways, what I'm doing right now is I am outlining the area of the fence. Now, it's going to be probably out to here is how big this fence is going to be, or how long this fence is going to be. And then it's going to go up a decent way. It'll probably go up probably above the ceiling of the warehouse, either that or it'll go just to the top of the warehouse. That way it'll keep all the Rexes out and stuff like that, because these pillars are pretty tall anyways, and it's already taller than Barry B. Benson the Baryonyx, so we're pretty good on that front. But what I'm doing right now is I'm just outlining the perimeter of the fence so that I can have kind of a visual of where the behemoth gate will be placed, which I have inside of my inventory. But I never realized how many freaking materials this was going to take. I guess I should have realized that. But yeah, so things are going along well. I've got the air conditioners inside of my inventory as well. I'm probably going to put them back in my RG. That way, if I die, I don't lose them. But yeah, so things are going quite well. It's going to look super freaking cool. I'm trying to decide whether or not I'm going to put walls down the side of these, or if I'm going to do the same thing I did back at the observatory and put spikes up. So I don't exactly know what I'm going to do, but I'm sure I'll figure it out sooner or later. But yeah, placing these pillars is starting out to be a little bit finicky. As you can see, you kind of have to look away from it for a second and then not look at it and then give it a present and then give it... it's stupid. It's really kind of weird about how you can't place a pillar right next to another pillar because the snap points are ridiculously weird. So I don't know what's up with that. Okay, there we go. Finally, it just freaking placed. So yeah, it's a little bit finicky, but I've got the patience to do it. And thankfully I have the patience or else I would have thrown this whole entire project out the window. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue to construct the... this thing, whatever it is, the incubation room, lost my train of thought. I'm going to continue to construct this thingy, and yeah, things are going along well, guys. We're going to be able to hatch that baby today. I can pretty much guarantee you that, and I can't wait to see that bad boy. And then we're probably going to store him either over here or over at the observatory, but we'll just have to wait and see. So I'm going to continue working, guys. And here she is, guys. One breeding chamber, whatever you want to call this thing, it's done. And it's amazing. And it's got power. So look at this, guys. What is going on inside of there? There's just a box floating around. Okay, but anyways, over here, guys, we've got the generator powering 12 air conditioners. 12 individual air conditioners. And in the middle of the room, look at the insulation for hypothermal and hyperthermal. 631 and 479, guys. This is crazy! Oh my freaking god, it's amazing. So, needless to say, it's working well. And I put glass in the front just to kind of equalize that, and I put glass in the back to give it the view. And I think I made my decision. I'm going to put spikes around the outside wall like this. That way, if Trudons come around, or if anything like that decides to come around, it will just get stuck in the spikes, and it will just slowly die. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. But I just wanted to bring you guys back in and show you how awesome this turned out. So inside of the walls, you can actually go inside of the wall and get up on top of it and do all that stuff. Because I put up ladders and stuff like that. And truthfully, I'm thinking about running cords from the one generator inside of there, inside of the, inside of these, and then running them along here, and then putting spotlights on top of here, and making it super lit up and stuff like that. But I mean, just look at the views, guys. It looks so freaking cool. It looks so good. I love the way this looks. But now it's time to put it to use. So we need to go ahead and fly on back to the observatory with Barry B. Benson, the Baryonyx, and, we need to get him back safely. We actually should probably stop off and get him some food first, but we need to get the spikes made up for the perimeter wall, and then we also need to get the egg back, or we need to bring the egg back to the incubation chamber and get that all worked up and get that going. So I might make the incubation chamber kind of a public building for people to use if they need a quick place to incubate their babies and then take them in, like full grown into the obelisk. Then I might do that, but yeah, I might just leave it unlocked just for everyone, just kind of a nice thing to do. And yeah, so I think what I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna go back, drop off Barry B. Benson, the Baryonyx, and maybe grab him some fish meat as well. I need to make sure my RG is fed too. She was almost at half health because she was starving to death because RGs don't freaking eat. And then I'm gonna make up the spikes, and then I'm gonna grab the egg, guys, and then it's crunch time because then I don't exactly know how much health we'll lose as we get closer and closer to the incubation chamber over there. So it's definitely going to be crunch time. So I'll see you guys soon. Alright, you guys, I'm coming in hot. My RG's eating all the freaking meat that I just got for this Rex, but I gotta make sure I get in there. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, egg is on my body. Come on, go, 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 go. Okay, let's just make sure we're good. We're good. Okay, good. I did not eat it. And it's incubating. Oh, it's incubating. Oh, that's such a good sign. Okay, we gotta keep it incubating. We just gotta keep it incubating. Let's go ahead and take all the meat off of you, Apex. Sorry, buddy. I'll get you meat later. All right, now I need to watch this shit like a hawk. Now, I know it's gonna go fairly quickly, but as soon as that health or as soon as it says too hot or too cold, I gotta press Y, because oh my god, I do not want to lose this Rex egg. So I'm gonna sit here and watch this thing incubate, guys. Hopefully the air conditioners are enough. I hope I don't need to have some campfires or stuff like that. I think nighttime is coming, so it's gonna get colder. Unfortunately, I did not choose the right time to do this. Probably should have waited until tomorrow around noon, but that's okay. We'll go ahead and deal with the time right now, and it's already almost to the end in incubation. So I'm gonna keep watching this guy, and hopefully everything goes well. Alright, you guys, any second now, this Rex is going to pop out of there. I hope it's twins. Watch it be twins. Oh my god, I've had luck in the past with breeding twins and triplets and stuff like that, so who knows, maybe it will be twins or triplets this time, but I've got 45 spiked walls on my bar right now. Oh, that was a huge lag spike, scared the crap out of me. So here we go. Oh, here we go, guys. Here she comes. Ooh, what do we got? Oh my god, it's twins! I was kidding! Oh my god, I can't freaking believe we got twins! Oh my god! Oh, is one a female and one a male? Or are they both females? I think they're both females. Damn, okay, well that's okay. That's okay. I can deal with two females. That is completely fine. Oh my freaking god. Oh, you know what? The male was the 150, the female of ours was the 145, which means we're going to be able to pass over the stats from the 150 to this one and see if we have any higher stats on that other one. So let's see. Change follow distance from medium to low, and we'll go ahead and lowest. All right, come here, big guys. Come on, little guys. Come on. Oh my god, look at them. Oh my god, look at them. They're so freaking adorable. Okay, can you stop crowding me? Okay, thank you. I appreciate that. All right, let's go ahead and, let's see, disable wandering. Don't know why you come out wandering anyways. Disable wandering. Okay, now we can whistle all stop, and we can go ahead and get inside of their inventories without them walking away from us. Oh my freaking god, you guys. We got twin female Rexes. Oh my god. I'm going to need so much more meat. Holy Jesus. I am going to need so much more meat. Holy crap. Okay, so, holy god. Okay, so let's look at their stats. What do we got? 10,120.6 health, 2,877 stamina, 20,550 food, 915 oxygen, 1,010 weight, 435.2 melee damage. Guys, holy Jesus, these guys are monsters. These are monster baby Rexes. This is amazing. These guys, I wonder if I can pass over any stats that are higher from my Rex, my 150 Rex, to these guys. I don't know. I think my oxygen is lower than theirs, so unfortunately I don't think I'll be able to pass over an oxygen stat, but who knows, maybe at least one of my stats is higher. So let's see, I've got it right in front of me right now. So it's got the same weight as mine. Oxygen, oh guys, I have a higher oxygen stat. Oh, that means I can get a higher leveled Rex every single time. As long as I pass over all the stats, the health, the stam, the oxygen, and all that stuff, yeah, absolutely, I can get a higher Rex. It's got higher, theirs has, or this one has higher food than mine, obviously higher melee, but we both have the same weight, and this one's got higher health and melee, so very, very freaking cool, guys. Holy crap. Okay, so these guys are going to be absolute monsters whenever we go into the boss fights, and to put this into perspective, guys, those Rexes that are out there right now, the ones down by Blue Obelisk, I was watching them fight a rogue T-Rex. They were doing like 800 damage by themselves, and mate boosted, they were doing like 1200 damage. And that's ridiculous. What in the hell is going on right there? That is a cluster screw of death. Look at that. Oh my god, those poor trikes. All right, what do we got right here? Watch this. What's going on right here? Your Rex is getting eaten, buddy. Wait, what level Rex did that say? 50? Okay, good. I just don't want to have to kill that one Rex right there. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get some more meat on those Rexes, guys. I might even build a trough so that when they turn juveniles, I don't have to stay there the whole time and they can just feed off the troughs. But, oh my god, I was kidding when I said I wanted twins. That's, oh Jesus, no. Oh god, the cluster screw came to me. Oh my god. All right, let's just go ahead and get some of this prime meat and get some of that meat off of her. Or get some of, yeah. Oh, I'm so flustered right now. There's just carnos attacking the shit out of me. Okay, no, I'm getting out of here. My bird is dying. Okay, so, oh my god, I still can't believe we got twins. That's so exciting, guys! That's two Rexes. Now all we need to do is get a male. And the cool thing is now that we have the two females, I can breed those with my Rex, get the oxygen stat, and then we can get a male from both of those, and then we're gonna have a perfect breeding pair, guys. A perfect breeding pair. And that's gonna be freaking amazing. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and keep these guys going, and then if anything crazy comes back in, or if anything crazy happens, I'll bring you guys back in. I am so flustered right now. Holy crap. Alright, guys, I'll be back. Alright, you guys, so the Rexes are juveniles, and look at them. They're just so happy. They're just so happy. They just want to give me kisses. Isn't that right? Just give me kisses. They're like big puppy dogs. I love them. So I got a trough inside of here, and it's full of meat. I'll probably fill it up occasionally here and there. Why is there keratin in there? T-Rexes don't eat keratin. But yeah, so these guys, they're all good to go. They're going to stay here. They're going to grow up. They're already at the, let's see, what stage of maturation? They're already at the U in maturation. So they'll be adolescents soon enough, and the spikes are up, guys. And actually, we already had our first altercation with an animal from the outside. It was a level 95 male Therizinosaurus. The dude got stuck on the spikes, but was destroying the stone. I had no idea that Therizinosauruses could do damage to stone, but now I know, and now you know. And the more you know, the more you're ready. So, anyways, guys, today has been amazing. We got to bring two Rexes into the world, and they are monsters. These things are amazing. And soon, they're going to have, like, a million babies. It's just gonna be a gigantic family of T-Rexes. Now, it's not gonna be a legitimate family of T-Rexes because, well, we're not gonna get into the, into all that stuff. But anyways, guys, today has been awesome. We got a brand new breeding chamber done, which is amazing. We're gonna be able to even breed Gigas in there once we get a Giga. And maybe even Quetzes. We'll be able to breed Therizinosauruses. We can breed those back at the house, because those guys are mammals, I assume. I think they're mammals. Yeah, I think they're mammals. But anyways, guys, today has been awesome, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. But with that being said, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end off today's episode right there. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode, and if you did, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos. There's just a Spino chilling in the water. Look at him, he's just chilling. Level 45 male, garbage. And if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter at CouchPotato1898. And I will see you guys in the next video.